Good morning students, welcome you again to online classes. Today I am going to start, actually I have already started this chapter, determinant of class 12 math. So up to exercise 4.2 I have already discussed. So today we will discuss about the exercise 4.3. Now 4.3 is actually the problem is regarding to calculate the area of a triangle. Now look, in previous class means class 10, you know a formula that suppose there are three point, one point is A whose coordinate is x1 comma y1 and another point B whose coordinate is x2 comma y2 and C whose coordinate is x3 comma y3. So if the points are non-collinear, so they will form a triangle like that. Now question is, what is the area of the triangle? What is the area of that triangle? Now look, we know that there is a formula to calculate the area of the triangle joining the point A, B and C. And what is the formula? The formula is area equal to half mod of x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. This was the formula to calculate the area of the triangle. But in determinant, how we can calculate the area of a triangle? Now look, if I consider a determinant, like x1, y1, 1, x2, y2, 1, x3, y3, 1, half determinant of. So if I expand the determinant, so it will be x1 into, it will be half x1 into, now when I consider x1, so we'll close this row and this column. So if then expand, so it will be y2 minus y3 and then minus x2 into. Now corresponding to this element, we have to close, we have to cover this row and this column, and that will be y1 minus y1 minus y3 plus x3 into, now for this element we have to cover this row and this column, so that is y1 minus y2. Now if I rearrange this equation, half x1 into y2 minus y3 plus, look, this is minus, so if I take minus 1 common from here, so it will be x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y2 minus y1 minus y2. So look, these two formula are same. So we can calculate the area of the triangle by determinant also. Now in this exercise, we'll calculate the area of a triangle using determinant. So finally I am writing the formula again. So area of the triangle joining the point x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2, x3 comma y3 is half determinant of. So find, write the first coordinate. So x1 y1 1,
So write the code in x1, y1, and the last column, all the element will be 1. Second row will be x2, y2, and 1. And the third row will be x3, y3, 1. So this formula will give you the area of the triangle joining the point x1, y1, x2, y2, and x3, y3. Now, using this formula, we'll calculate the area of the triangles given in a problem exercise of 4.3. Okay, so let's start the exercise. Remember this formula. Okay, so exercise 4.3, question number 1 is, suppose 1, 1. So find the area of the triangle with vertices at the point given each of the following. So the first coordinate is 1, 0. Second point is 6, 0. And the third point is 4, 3. So we have to calculate the area of the triangle joining these three points. So this is our x1, this is y1, this is x2, y2, and x3 and y3. So area of the triangle, area of the triangle joining the points, joining the points this 1, 0, 6, 0, and 4, 3 is, now apply this formula written over there. So half determinant of, so formula is x1, y1, 1. So this is our x1, this is y1, and 1. Second row will be x2, y2, 1. So x2 is 6, y2 is 0, and the third element will be 1. And for the third one, it will x3, y3, 1. So x3, y3, 1. Now this is a determinant of order 2, and we know how to expand the determinant. Now look, if I expand the determinant along the second column, because it contains maximum number of 0, so we'll expand this determinant along its second column. So half into, now so 0 into, now for this 0 we have to cover this row and this column. So it will be 6 1s are 6 minus 4 1s are 4. So 0 into 6 minus 4. That will be 0. Something multiplied by 0 is, result will be give 0. Second element will be plus. This 0 into, now cover this row and this column. So it will be 1 minus 4. 1 minus 4. And the third will be, again, minus 3 of, so corresponding to this element, we have to cover this row and this column. So it will be 1, 1 is a 1 minus a 6, 1 minus 6. Okay, so we have our x1, the determinant, now we have to calculate. So that is half. Now that quantity will be 0. Plus again 0, and this will be 1 minus 6, that is equal to 15, 5 5 3 is 15. So that is 15 by 2 square unit. So area of the triangle joining these three points is 15 by 2 square unit. So you see that the process is very easy. Three points will be given to you. We have to just apply this formula to calculate the area. Okay? And the process is like that. I hope you understand. Okay, so let's move to another problem. Suppose question number 1, 3. I'm solving one more problem. Okay, so suppose question number 3. So we have to calculate the area of the triangle joining the point -2, -3. Second point is 3, 2, and the third point is -1, -8. So area of the triangle. So area of the triangle. Area of the triangle joining this 3 point, -2, -3, 3, 2, and -1, 8 is, now apply the formula, half determinant of, so formula is x1 y1 1. So here x1 is -2, y1 is -3, and third element will be 1. Second point is x2 y2 1, so x2 y2 1, and third row will be x3 y3 1. So this is the area of the triangle. Now what we have to do, we have to just calculate this determinant. Now look, as this two element corresponding to the third column R1, so with the help of this one we can convert into 0 by using a transformation. What is this? That is half. Now look, if I use the transformations, let R2 dot equal to R2 minus R1 and R3 dot equal to R3 minus R1. So if I apply this transformation here, so the first row will be unchanged, -2, -3, 1, and this will be 3 minus of -2, 3 minus of -3, that will be equal to 5. This element will be 2 minus of -3, 2 minus of -3 is again 5, and this element will be 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. The element corresponding to this position will be -1, -2, and that will be equal to +1. 8 minus of -3, and that will be equal to 11, and that element will be equal to 0. That element will be equal to 0. So now calculate it. So element corresponding to these two positions are 0. So if I expand the determinant along the third column, so the calculation will be very easy. So half, so cover this row and this column and multiply. 11 5s are 55, -5 1s are 5, so that is equal to half into 50, and that is equal to 25. So area of the triangle joining this 3 point is equal to 25 square unit. This is the procedure. So it is a very easy process. Clear? Now let's solve question number 2. It is a formula. Okay, question number 2 is, show that the points, point A, B+C, this is A, B equal to B, C+A, and the third point is C equal to C, A+B. Show that the points are collinear. So we call, what do you mean by collinear? So collinear point means if the points lying on a line, then the points are said to be collinear point. Suppose there is a line and 3 points, suppose A, B and C, all are lying on the same points, so we can say that the points are collinear point. Now see what happens when the points are collinear point. Suppose there is a triangle ABC, A, B, and C, and let AD is the distance of the point A from the line BC. So area of the triangle will be half into base into height. Suppose height is AD equal to H. Now what if when the distance of the point A, distance of A from the line BD is gradually decreasing. So if I move the point A closer to the line BC, so whenever the height decrease, the area of the triangle is also decreased, and when these points coincide with this line, then height will be equal to zero. And in that case, area of the triangle will be half into BC into zero, will be zero. That means when three points are collinear, then the area of the triangle formed by these three points will be equal to zero. So this is the concept we'll use here to calculate whether the points are collinear or not. Now see, it is given that three points are there, we have to check whether the line points are collinear or not. So to check whether the lines are collinear or not, we have to check whether the area of the triangle formed by these three points are zero or not. If the area is zero, then we can say the points are collinear. And if the area is not equal to zero, we can say the points are non-collinear. Okay, so see, the area of the triangle joining these three points will be equal to half determinant of x1, y1, 1, x2, y2, this is x2, y2, and 1. And third point is x3, y3, 1. Now you can expand the determinant or you can use the property also. So if I use the property here, so half determinant of, we're applying a c1 dot equal to c1 plus c2, means we are adding the element of c1 and the corresponding element of c2. The first element will be a plus b plus c, b plus c, 1. Second element will be a plus b plus c, c plus a, 1. And the c a plus b plus c, a plus b, and 1. Now from this column we can take a plus b plus c common. So if I take a plus b plus c common, so we can say that half determinant of half take common a plus b plus c. So a plus b plus c determinant of 1 1 1, if I take common a plus b plus c common from the first column, second element will be b plus c, c plus a plus b, and third element will be 1 1 1. Now you can recall a formula that if two row or column of a determinant are identical, then the value of the determinant is equal to 0. Now see, in that determinant the first column and third column are identical, so value of the determinant will be 0. So half a plus b plus c multiplied by 0, that is equal to 0. That means the area of the triangle joining these three points is equal to 0. So the points are collinear. Okay. So let's solve question number 3. There are two questions. We'll solve one question and you try to solve the another question by yourself. Okay. So I am solving question number 1. 3, 1. Find the value of K if the area of the triangle is 4 square mm. It is given that the area of the triangle joining the point K, 0, 4, 0, and 0, 2, area of the triangle joining these three points is 4 unit, it is given. So area of the triangle joining these three points will be half determinant of x1, y1, 1, x2, y2, 1,
x3, y3, 1. Okay, so now expand the determinant. Okay, if we expand the determinant along the third column, the second column, so it will be very easy because it contains 2 0. So if I expand the determinant along the second column, so it will be half determinant of, okay, so 0 into 0 into actually minus 0, you know the sign of plus minus plus minus plus minus plus minus plus. Okay, so this is the minus. So minus 0 into cover this row and this column, it will be 4 minus 0. For this one, plus 0 into, so cover this row and this column, so it will be k minus 0. And for this one, again minus 2 into, cover this row and this column, it will be k minus 4. It will be k minus 4, k minus 4. Okay, so expand. So this, that quantity will be 0, that quantity will be also 0. So it will be half of minus 2 into k minus 4. Half and 2 will cancel, so that is a 4 minus k. But it is given that the area of the triangle is 4 unit. So this quantity, that is 4 minus k, will be equal to plus minus 4. So here we can see that there are two equation. Solving these two equation, we have two values of k. So first we take 4 minus k is equal to plus 4, and 4 minus k is equal to minus 4. So solve this equation. For here, k will be equal to 0, and here k will be equal to 8. So value of k is either 0 or 8. Okay. Question number 2 is as same as question number 1. Okay, so I am leaving the question. I am solving question number 4 now. Question number 4. Now in question number 4, there are two questions of same type. So we'll solve one question and one, it try to do it. I am solving question number 4 1. Find the equation of the line joining the point 2, 1, 2. Suppose there is a line. One point is A whose coordinate is 1, 2, and there is another point B whose coordinate is 3, 6. So we have to calculate what is the equation of the line joining these two points. Now to find out the equation of the line, we'll consider another point. So value of the determinant is can be written as the form summation of Aij into capital Aij, where this is the element corresponding to I comma j place, and this is the cofactor. This is the cofactor corresponding to this element. Okay, so we can calculate the value of the determinant by adding the products of the element and the cofactor of the corresponding element. Okay. We are going to apply this conception to solve some problem. Okay. So next question means question number, suppose question number 4, so question number 3, using the cofactor of the element of the second row, evaluate determinant of 5, 3, 8, 2, 0, 1, 1, 2, 3. We have to calculate the value of the determinant using cofactor of the element of the second row. Of the second row means along this row we have to expand the determinant. So what we have to do? We have to calculate the cofactor corresponding to element of the second row. So the adjoint cofactor of the first element of the second row means A21, that is the cofactor of A21, and that is equal to minus 1 whole to the power 2 plus 1 into its minor. So minor means
cover this row and this column. So 3823. Okay, now calculate it, 3823, and that will be equal to 3 3 is 9 and 16. So that is -7, that is equal to +7. Okay, now A22 means cofactor of the element A22, and that is equal to -1 whole to the power 2 plus 2 into determinant of cover this row and this column, 5 8 1 3. Now if I expand this, so 15 minus 8 is equal to again 7, and A2,3 means cofactor of the element A2,3, and that is equal to -1 whole to the power 2 plus 3 determinant of, so 2,3 is this element, cover this row and this column, 5 3 1 2. So 10 minus 3 is equal to 7 and the sign is negative, so -7. So that are the cofactor of the element corresponding to the second. Now value of the determinant will be, therefore value of the determinant is equal to, look the formula, summation of Aij, capital Aij. Okay, so it will be A21 into capital A21 plus A22 capital A22 plus A23 capital A2,3. Put the value. Okay, A21 is equal to 2. 2 into A22 is 7. Plus 0 into 7 plus, that is 1 into -7. So 14 plus 0 minus 7, and that is equal to 7. So value of the determinant is equal to 7. See? Okay. Now question number 4. Using the cofactors of the element in the third of the third column, evaluate the determinant. So process is same as we have done here. So try to solve it. Okay, and question number 5 is an multiple type question. You can solve it easily. Okay, so question number 4.4 is completed. Now look, next day we'll proceed to the next exercise, that is 4.5. I hope you understand this one, how to calculate the minors and cofactors, and using the cofactor how we can calculate the value of the determinant. Okay, so let's next we'll solve the remaining problem. Okay, thank you.